Welcome to the Spy Collection. I'm Anastasios and this time we have another video based on NSA's leaked ANT or Advanced Network Technologies catalogue. It's covering an NSA capability, codenamed Gopherset, which allowed NSA to install backdoors inside SIM cards. Let's dive into it. First, who inside NSA was doing that? As we read, the point of contact was S32222. S stands for Signals Intelligence Directorate, and S3 was NSA's data acquisition, basically the people tasked with collecting intelligence with a variety of means. S32 was NSA's hackers, the Tailored Access Operations. As its name implies, TAO was an office of hackers in NSA that was handling cases of very specific, tailored needs that weren't covered by the wider collection capabilities of the agency. S322 was ANT, the owners of that leaked catalogue, focusing on network-based capabilities. And S3222 was the branch of NSA software engineers that were developing what NSA called software implants, meaning backdoors written in software. And S3222 was a sub-team of that branch whose formal name isn't publicly known. As we read, this was available back in January of 2007 for operational use. But it wasn't deployed yet. And since it was an in-house developed backdoor, it didn't have any particular cost associated with it if someone wanted to employ that for an intel gathering operation. But what was Gopherset? The subscriber identity modules, or SIM cards, that people use every day to get access to the cellular network aren't only storing very sensitive information, but they also have some tiny applications installed. As NSA said, Gopherset is a software implant for GSM, Global System for Mobile Communications, Subscriber Identity Module, SIM, cards. The implant pulls phone book, SMS, and call log information from a target handset and exfiltrates it to a user-defined phone number via SMS. Then we have the simple diagram indicating how it operated. First, NSA operatives had to either physically get someone's cell phone or remotely trick them to install Gopherset on their SIM card. Then, once activated, it decrypts the trigger and parses the instructions. It retrieves the requested information and builds an SMS message with that, then encrypts it and sends it to the configured number so that NSA can collect it. The brochure continued that modern SIM cards, Phase 2 Plus, have an application program interface known as the SIM Toolkit, SDK. The SDK has a suite of proactive commands that allow the SIM card to issue commands and make requests to the handset. Gopherset uses SDK commands to retrieve the requested information and to exfiltrate data via SMS. After the Gopherset file is compiled, the program is loaded onto the SIM card using either a USB smart card reader or via over-the-air provisioning. In both cases, keys to the card may be required to install the application, depending on the service provider's security configuration. Apparently, the spying capabilities of a backdoor in a SIM card are particularly useful for hard targets that, let's say, switch from one device to another but reuse the same SIM card, or they take extreme precautions on protecting their mobile devices and so on. Worth noting here that since then, the ability to backdoor SIM cards has only increased. For example, in 2013 at Black Hat USA, security researcher Carsten Knoll presented how he took advantage of a SIM card's feature to execute Java applications and develop a quite more advanced backdoor than what NSA had back in 2007. Or even more recently, in Black Hat Europe 2017, a group of university researchers presented how they exploited SIM cards remote provisioning. We'll leave links in the description for both of those presentations, but they are good indicators of what future iterations of Gopherset might look like. Any component that can execute commands in a system, willingly or unwillingly, is a target for SIGINT agencies. Even to this day, with the amount of readily available information on the SIM card weaknesses, many would not even consider that this tiny little chip here could be hiding an advanced network implant. This is why Gopherset remains a great example of how nothing is as it seems.